Steve's concerned,
all right, we're going to go ahead and get started. As you recall, at yesterday's meeting, end of the day, we were kind of in the middle of reviewing and discussing our ordinances. We have staff here with us this morning, so we're going to kind of move on over into our second day agenda, and then we'll fall back and pick up ordinances to finish that up. I want to go ahead and let's get started and dive right on in into utilities. Steve, welcome. Thank you for coming.
Sorry.
And what was yours?
You gave me the water sewer tabs. There's some information right before that. Studstill at Skipper Bridge and come right back up to Stafford, Wright. We'll run Stafford, Wright, and then we'll take Staten Road up to the power line easement where we currently have our sewer easement, and we'll follow that sewer easement with the that's in the power line easement. And in looking at that, we can drop and follow that sewer easement all the way, but we got to look at it. Felt like it would be best to peel off that sewer easement onto Sermon's Lane, because that'll give us the ability to serve some customers possibly, but it'll also line us up better on in the Sermon's Lane. It comes right out of the north entrance of Nelson Hill, which is, and then Clyattstone Road is just a few feet up from that, and Clyattstone is on the paving list, and again, some good color property there. And in time, it's going to include that. That will give us a route straight across to 41. So, like I say, on some other maps, you'll be able to see it a good bit better. But in looking at that, that turned out to be about 33,550 feet, and with a cost of 6160 a foot. That estimated cost is about $2 million, a little over $2 million. One thing I love wanted to do is, for our purposes here, again, this being just budgetary numbers to look at, $2,686,000. I'm just going to go ahead and tell you my thoughts on the 30%. I'm sure we're going to do that when it comes down to it. But one of the things he said, you know, not knowing how long out we might be on some of these projects, he just wanted to put that in. The other thing that I feel like, and what I've talked to with some different ones, as we look through the rest of these, I believe if we're able to put a couple or a few of these projects together and get a $5 million job, I think we're going to draw outside interest and that'll do a couple of things. We'll get a little bitter and, you know, maybe it'll be our local people, they'll sharpen their pencils too. And so I think, you know, if we can get a little bit larger projects, we'll draw that without any problem. Area two is where we catch there at Highway 84 and James Road, and we'll take it through going south, and we'll follow our current sewer easement through the woods there on Lockman Farms, and that will go down to Indian Ford Road, and we'll follow it out right with that sewer easement all the way out to Old Clyattville, and then we'll tie back in with the 12 there at Charles Cowher's property. Those prices on the water, the price is all the same per foot, but the distance there is 19,575 feet. The estimated cost is $1.2 million, and with the contingency, $1.567 million. As I told you earlier, we also look at some weaknesses, and that's where Area 3 comes in. At exit 11, we have an 8-inch line feeding from the west side of the interstate over to the east side. And while we typically don't have much problems, as we look to grow and everything, and currently with our booster station that we have in, if we have to keep it on to provide fire protection at Lowndes Middle, we could have some problems. Now, we're currently holding that pressure on average usage, but with that 8-inch suction line, it just don't seem to provide enough water. So my goal there on Area 3 is to come in on Whitewater Road, just below exit 11, where Whitewater starts to peel, peel back away from the interstate. We'll bore the interstate, and right across there, there's Touchton Road, the extension or Touchton Lane, where Mr. Percy has his operation there. We would follow that up Touchton Road, round up Touchton Road, and across Caroll Ulmer to Lock Laurel and tie us on a 12-inch right there. And that would give us a good solid feed on the east side of the interstate in that area to continue on with our areas 4 and 5 to shouldn't have any issue then with plenty of water pressure doing that. That's a very small project, 8,675 feet. In all actuality, it was a different area, so I split it out. But I feel like we would certainly do area 2 and 3 together. back from the fire department, Moore Crossing Road. You would follow Moore Crossing all the way through to Lakeland Highway, and then I lost the road name right there, but it'll pick up right beside the substation there on Lakeland Highway, through that dirt road. And this would be one area where we felt like it would be best to see if we can acquire an easement. I don't recall exactly the number of feet there, but there's really no significant reason to go up and shut right back if we could acquire this easement. I believe that's the plan of property. And then that will allow us right back up on Knights Academy Road. And
the title of the
Stalvey's is what that is. Stalvey's Road would be the one we would follow until we broke off on that land property. And then we would be able to go right up Bemiss Heights and attach to our Spring Creek system up there. And that would have us looped all the way around. It would have us with the 12 inch all the way around. We're not looking right now at additional wells. Here we can determine that as we go, if we need to put in any additional wells to supply anything. We want to study that very carefully and try to put them in areas where we would not have to do treatment. That would be back over in the Caroll area. And I've heard some information that there's a possibility of a little bit closer pay hour. We have some good water here that would require treatment. Again, that's not part of this, but it's something to keep in mind. When we start talking about sewer, that really gets into a lot more money and everything. Of course, we have sewer all the way around from Bemis all the way around on the west side now, and that goes all the way down to the LAS. Area 4 under the sewer heading there would be picking up at Lester and Copeland Road, and again coming out to the perimeter and following it all the way up to the fire station again. And again, that distance was 35,263 feet. And the pricing on that come out to $1 million, and then with a 30% contingency, $1.2 million being that's just on the force main. And I'll have a couple maps up here that we'll be able to take a look at, and I think y'all can see a lot better at the break. We level broke that out in the force main and gravity, and then in the manhole of the pumping station. So let me back up and say that was a little misleading at first number I gave you. Force main figure is close to $1 million. Gravity is 1.1. They need 500,000 worth of manholes and about 675,000 worth of pump stations for a total of 3.3 million and 4.3 million on the with the contingency. What we looked at there was the ability to serve most of everything through that area either by force or gravity. Obviously, the force will be running the whole way, but we will utilize the gravity as best we can in between those areas. And again, when we get to the break, I'll set another map up that shows out on Area 4 on the sewer, and you'll be able to see that. Area 5 sewer is the same way. Again, it's a bit more requiring a bit more stations and manholes. But the total there is 4.8 and then contingency 6.3. My personal thoughts, and obviously y'all make that decision, but my thought is look at the big scheme on the summary page, if you look at all five areas for work, one thing that we did is we added in water power. I feel like that price is a little high. I did get a price from a different company in early 16, and that price was 1.4 million or 500,000 gallons of elevated tank. Again, I had some other ones put this together, so that's why I printed out across the board. I think that one could be a touch high. Overall, the water would be looking at 9.4 million, and the 30% contingency, 12,258,000. The sewer, with you can see the breakout on each area there, and then with the total is 8 million, and then with the 30% contingency is 10.7 million. All total with everything, we have the ability to do that, 17.6 million, and with 30% contingency, 22, right at 23 million. Again, I think a safe figure to be looking at there is, again, if we got some sure of competitive bidding in here, maybe we could look at more of my first estimates all the way up and down the board. You know, the longer we wait, the construction picks up and all those prices and everything's high, we'll be closer to our 30%. Any questions at this point on that?
Not anything that really would hold me to something, but my thoughts are is that the survey is extremely important for the future of our water and sewer system, that we continue to develop that, continue to grow it, continue to invest in that infrastructure for the benefit of growth. As you said, you're talking about 22, 23 million, possibly it's a good bidding and lower contingency. We could be somewhere in the 20, 21 million dollars. That would be good. What kind of realistically have you kind of put some thought into what the timeline would be if we said we want to go ahead and complete this infrastructure?
Yep.
Revenue in mind.
And if it's on the bottom of that page, I failed to go through that. If the projected swap funds, again, that's the projected, is somewhere between 8.5 and 9 million through 2020. You know, I really feel like with those swap funds being what we have right now, I see no reason we could probably move forward on that north area one now and then look at that. And quite possibly before that was completed, let's go ahead and wrap up area to complete. And then I think if our funds are holding up, then I'm sure we'll be looking at another spot scheme. And funds are already, so we move right on to area four. Time-wise, I think, again, I don't see why we couldn't begin to get the wheels rolling on the first one. Now, another one certainly within a couple of years, if not sooner.
So, Chair, Commissioners, when Steve first came on board, our focus was to review the status of our existing infrastructure and go through and make sure that infrastructure was properly maintained, up to speed, and if any maintenance needed to be made to improve that, that's where we were focusing our attention. With the understanding that these development projects would be forthcoming. So Steve has spent that first year both assessing the existing infrastructure as well as looking at this, and this came on a little bit later. But also remember from yesterday Harrison's discussion about those funds that had some flexibility in them as opposed to brick and mortar. So we may need to keep a close watch on that SPLOS, those SPLOS funds for your total
project. And I would agree, and again, Steve and his wisdom in planning the process, realizing that that the revenue is just not there to complete the entire park. But realistically, if we don't go ahead and make an effort to take that step and start the process, then we'll be sitting here next year talking about doing the same thing, the following year the same thing, but just trying to put this further behind it.
Right.
So, I like what I have heard, the standpoint of the planning. I like certainly the plan of looping everything together to make sure that we have redundancy throughout the whole system.
Right.
That's basically, at the end of the day, that's what that would create. And I think that those issues are the ones that we do need to focus on, as Steve said, to begin to create that looping process and tying several of these systems together, which in turn then would give you the redundancy that we need from one area to the next. But with the ultimate goal of tying the whole system all the way around and being able then to be in a position to be able to serve the citizens of Lowndes County and that growth and whatever side of that area that it may grow on. We don't know what the east side about us is going to do. Certainly the high school will have a role to play in that. Typically, I've said this before, but typically in the past, history has shown that east of Perimeter Road in that area has been really a slow growth area. There's a lot of weapons in there, a lot of different obstacles that has to overcome. But reality is that it's still potentially with the new high school there, it could begin to grow over there. So I like the plan. Anybody have any questions?
I like the plan and the concept of the loop, but I can't honestly say that I think we need to do the phase, maybe the area one first, and then also, we got the knowledge of SPLOS list that was created prior to those projects in which that we budgeted for from SPLOS 7, and the previous commission and so forth that aren't to their positions to a certain degree. I just don't want to forget about that until the splash is that kind of that's my only concern. And I realize how much money we're talking. And I realize the big picture. I definitely see phase one definitely as being very important. I guess, like you said, in the future, I just reminded of that risk that we did until the
process. Well, I would think that, Ms. Walsh, I would think some of your thoughts on some of the splash water and sewer projects at that particular phase also have a lot to do with the roads as well, any new paving, any different areas like that. However, we do know that because of revenue, we just haven't been able to be as aggressive in those areas as we'd like. For example, the Clyattstone Road is a good example. That is an area there potentially for future development. But we know we've got to have the money in there and pave the road, and then that put the infrastructure in there about the same time, my thought. So some of that plays off one and the other. From my standpoint, I listened to what Mr. Stalvey is saying, and he has taken all the consideration of what those other projects are, along with the system as a whole. And I just want to be very, very confident that our system as a whole is well connected, we have our redundancy, and it serves the citizens of Lowndes County. And forget about, rather than concentrate, and so if you get this understood, I don't want to necessarily concentrate on a little project here, and a little project here, and a little project here, and then we forget about the system as a whole. Because that's the most important thing to me, is that system is solid, it's in good shape, and we continue to grow in its redundancy. With looping is extremely important in my opinion.
The system of these prices is additional capacity as far as the capacity.
Steve, you've talked about Sprayfield a little bit about, because that's been a big part of your focus on looking at that facility.
Right. We, I was going to tell Mr. Smaller later on to do it now. I know you was driving through that area a little over a year ago working on a project. I would encourage you to drive right through there. Hopefully you'll notice a considerable change.
I'll do that.
But we have worked down there a lot. One of the things that we were weak in, that we knew that before just looking at this, that Sprayfield has to have a dedicated attention, and it don't necessarily require attention every day of the week for from full 8 to 10 hours or something. But I do have a gentleman that is assigned there now, and his extra time goes from there. But that has helped us a lot with working to get that brought back up. As you recall, where we applied for that Jeep along with forgiveness, and we're proceeding with that. That's going to help us. We got a couple of areas that we're bumping against our permit, and occasionally we go over on a couple of different parameters there, and that's what we're looking at on that, is trying to get that all in place, some new equipment, and then rehabbing some equipment that we currently have. All of it was working properly. We've noticed a considerable difference there in that.
That brings up a good question to me from the standpoint again for planning of growth. Where are we at, in your opinion, with capacity with this plant?
As far as capacity goes, we still have a good bit on our current permit. I mean, we don't come close to our capacity. We're hitting 60% of capacity normally any given month, 60, sometimes 70, but so we still got quite a bit of capacity. But
good.
Steve, can I ask you to show us on the map what your first proposal will be as far as, I guess, just water, right?
Yes, sir. Basically, you can see it pretty good here. I've got it on the water. The water map is in purple. If you can't see when you get up, maybe you'll be able to see it a lot better. But it catches over here on the FEMA side. This FEMA's road here, maybe up here. And right here at Studstill Road, Fred's in that area. I'm going to catch it there and bring it down Studstill to right at close to the bottom of Skipper Bridge at Cherry Creek Baptist Church, if you want to get exact. And then we'll have to go back up just a little bit. We're going to go ahead and catch Stallings Road. No.
Stafford Wright.
I get some of them roads confused there. Stafford Wright here. We looked at ore. That is a straight shot, but Stafford Wright gets us closer to being able to service this area here that is currently our service area that we want to maintain. Then we'll just go straight up, and we'll catch the power line right here, follow the power line, and then this is where it comes out, Sermons Road right there.
That's the first project.
That would be what I would recommend as the first project. Again, we can look at this and we can look at our splice and our projections on all that. Ideally, if we get this one and this one and this area of 1, 2, and 3, that will really set us up very well with our water. We you know, if we had anything go down, then we could keep going. We wouldn't have an issue. Right now, you know, if Spring Creek goes down, we dead in the water. But I mean, the one thing we have there is the elevated tank that gives us a lot. I say we're dead in the water. We have to start buying from the city of Valhalla. That's our backup plan. Where if we get this tied on, it's no longer our backup plan. We support ourselves. And then likewise down here, if we get our south and Kennerloo and our north all tied together, we can maintain through just about anything. I mean, lack of a major hurricane that took out, you know.
How quick do you use the contract?
Well,
I would say I think you're not looking to do it 1, 2, and 3 all at the same time.
I like that idea because I feel like that we'll get some good competitive bidding in here. And when you look at 1, 2, and 3 together, that's not real bad.
Well, that's what. Yeah. And through your explanation and doing the 1, 2, and 3, that accomplishes the two goals that I feel like it's extremely important, and that's the redundancy in the system, which is going to give the citizens of this community confidence that we'll be able to survive in the water.
Yep.
And then secondly, it's going to prepare us on that, in that old quarter down there. And certainly even in that east area, that exit 13 and 11 all that area right in there, to be sure to give us some potential for growth there. So it's extremely important.
You just decided there, one of the bridges that I'm going to talk to you about is Stafford Wright. We require 100% of the right of way on Stafford Wright. So you will not need any easements or anything to put his water line in there. So he's 100% ready to go on Stafford Wright as far as right of way easements or anything that he would need.
There's one small easement that would possibly be needed here at Sermons Road. And then other than that one and the one over on Project 5 of the water and sewer on that Blanton property, other than that, it should be very minimal on easements. I would think that we wouldn't have much of anything. Obviously, the power company. And you will see on Area 5 over here on the sewer, especially on the other smaller maps here that Lowell put together, there might be a little bit of shorter version in a place or two. But, you know, I look at it like this. If we can maybe save 500 foot by going through a power easement that we're never going to serve anything off of versus 500 to 1,000 here, we stay on a road that's got property on it, that's where we need to go.
Yeah.
How does this lay with, if we overlay this with our comprehensive plan and stuff Jason does for us, because this is going to spur development, right?
Yeah, that's
part of it, return on investment and so forth. So when we look at our comprehensive plan, I'd be interested to know,
well,
immediately, are the developers going to be attracted to this?
One thing I looked at early on was whether or not we would go up north here and catch this on Skipper Bridge and Macmillan. And yes, that's a lot, but in talking to Jason, he felt like we needed to connect down here to take care of our needs here. But in the master plan, this area is a little bit better than jumping way out here. This gets a little bit ahead of ourselves, according to Jason.
Yeah, that plan. Design there, you'll be able.
In time, we'll catch it right here at Lowndes Middle School, drop here, and we'll come across Macmillan all the way across the Valley, and we'll be right there, to where we look again.
If you look under this void over, the zoning map is in there with all the activity we've all had in the past year, and it kind of shows you those zoning designations for those areas as it kind of reflect there.
You're talking about Clyattstone. You can come across Clyattstone there. Clyattstone, we have, I know in the last probably 3 months, I talked to at least four different people on Clyattstone Road that are asking, when's the road going to be paved? Where can we get water? But they're ready to get the Washington property that we rezoned, and a couple more that are ready to move forward.
It's contrary to all that drama we had before when they were behind us looking at pavement, remember?
They want pavement.
Okay. Any questions?
In your packet here, these are the maps Steve was referring to, the painting level that you give you. Additional detail, five of those, there's an overall of the
section. All right, if there's no other questions, I know that Mr. Stalvey has some other urgent county business that he needs to get to, so feel free to leave any time you need to.